Congratulations.
Thank you.
First film.
First movie.
And it's really good.
Oh, thank you.
How do you get Richard Gere to star in your first film?
Well, I inherited this trove of blackmail photographs. No. I sent him the screenplay. I spent 9 months writing it, and I wanted to make it. We thought originally, my producer and I, were going to make the movie for $200,000 in my backyard. And, you know, there was no one really to play the part. I thought I might put on age makeup and do it myself. But every director is really a frustrated actor. But, you know, the one human being who could probably do this part properly was Richard Gere, because he's a unique American actor. He's an icon. He's had a 40-year career. He's worked with Akira Kurosawa. He's worked with Terrence Malick. I mean, the list of directors is insane. I didn't think it was particularly realistic that we would get Richard Gere to be in the movie, because we didn't have any money, and I was a nobody. But we sent him the screenplay. His agent really liked it. And he said, listen, do you think you could get an actual proper movie together? And we said, yeah. And he said, okay, well, I'm going to give the script to Richard. And so he did. And Richard called back 18 hours later. And he said, you know, I really like the script. I want to meet this. Who is this kid? I want to meet him. Mm-hmm. And I go up to meet him, and he said, listen, this is a good script. How do I know you can make a movie? You never made a movie. What are we gonna do about that? I mean, can you even show me like a music video? Do you have sound? No, I got nothing. So he said, okay. He said, well, why don't we start working? Let's rehearse, let's get loose, drink some tea, and talk about this, because I think we could have something here. And I was just totally into it. You know, we had a real kinship that developed very quickly, and we started rehearsing. We spent about a month in my apartment going through the screenplay, and we went on field trips, sat down with Susan Sarandon, and took Britt Marling to the New York Stock Exchange. You know, we went in the Federal Reserve area. I mean, we got deep in this role, and Richard got deep in it. And one of the things that interested him from the beginning was doing this, a character with a little bit darker side. We wanted to make a cool movie, you know, a classic thriller, a kind of business gangster movie with a lot of twists and turns. You didn't know what was happening. But we also wanted to be a bit more of a character movie that would get people going, you know, internally, on that dramatic level of asking the deeper questions. So really it was him putting his trust in me, along with the rest of the cast, that made the film possible.
Can you talk a little bit about the title? Because I think there's four different ways of saying it that I've heard within my office.
Well, arbitrage is actually, it's a French word, but it's a business term. And what it really means is to buy low and to sell high, and that's what every businessman wants to do. But the way you do it is by exploiting a special knowledge that you have. You know, I get this special water over here, and I can sell it over there for a dollar more. But I have a limited amount of time, and if anyone knew, I wouldn't make it, right? So I thought, okay, Richard Gere, he's the businessman in this movie. He's the consummate hedge fund manager, but really he's the emotional arbitrageur, because he's got all these people in his life who love him. We see his family, his beautiful wife, his brilliant daughter. He's even got his godson, Jimmy, you know, these people looking out for him. And he buys them very cheap, and he gets a lot from them. So, you know, he's doing arbitrage on many levels.
And if nothing else, it's a cool-sounding word.
It is a cool-sounding word, and, you know, hopefully it provokes you into the theater.
Yeah. It's a New York movie. It feels very, it captures that, the vibe of the city. What are the key New York movies for you that
you
looked at?
Well, I love New York movies. I'm born and raised in New York. So, you know, we're talking about, I mean, you can be going back to the 1940s movies in New York, but, you know, films that are here are Wall Street, you know. I love particularly the 70s movies. I love thrillers. I love The French Connection, Billy Friedkin. I love, you know, the Godfather and Being on the Outskirts. But, you know, New York is such a rich place. You know, we went to the real places where all the billionaires went. So we're in the Four Seasons. That's the Maitre d'. We're in the Plaza Hotel in the ballroom. Richard's office in the movie. That's one of the major hedge funds in New York. We use the city to our benefit. We put all these people in there as extras and, you know, door openers, and they gave us their restaurants and their offices and their places to shoot. And also just being on the streets of New York with the camera. You get a certain type of light. You get a certain type of grit in the sidewalk. We shot the movie on 35 millimeter. We didn't want to go digital. We wanted old school cigarette smoke on the print, you know, one of those gut movies they might have played at 42nd Street back in the day. So Richard Gere is the business gangster doing battle with a pen.